mountains locate Colette Sierra, all mountain in the northern Ouray Mountains of Russia.
We have this location.
And please locate Dyatlov Pass on the east shoulder of this mountain on the night of February 2nd, 1959.
Location again.
Dyatlov Pass on the shoulder of the mountain.
We have this particular location here.
And the night being February 2nd, 1959.
We have this place.
On this evening, 9 ski hikers passed away when an unknown, compelling force frightening them into fleeing their camp in freezing weather. Please locate this scene and describe in some detail what occurred here, including from the hiker's perspective, what caused them to run from their tents.
I find as we look through these particular areas or records, at first there were 3 floating metal objects here that would represent 3 lights, or like flashlights on the side of a bowl, they would be protruding. We then would find rotation of these lights, which would be somewhat amber, but not quite dark in their coloration. And we have some also intrusion here as to large beasts that would be somewhat, call them furry or hairy, you'll say. And here there was 3 or 4, a group of these, at the same time or simultaneously in the area itself, you'll say. There would be some disturbance, as there would be some observation of these bright lights in otherwise a dark environment, or what would be supposedly unlit region of the sky and the pass, or valley as you might call it. These marauding animals were also attracted, and we could see some hysteria and some fear and some excitement, mixed emotions from the group itself. To the question itself, we would see that there would be a degree of panic, and there was some falling down, there was some attack. These looked to be somewhat similar to gorillas, although they are much thicker in matted fur or hair. And we would see here some violence being done to the human bodies, you'll say, as if being beaten upon like a gorilla, stomping both fists into the ground, not jumping up and down per se, but double-fisting punches, so to speak, or bouncing on the shoulders, hands on the ground, or in essence pounding the human bodies, we'll say, randomly, just as long as there was no motion, and then they moved on. It seemed like the beasts were as frightened as the humans, you'll say, direction.
Why was there radioactive contamination on some of their clothes?
Due to the radioactive exhaust from these ships, you'll say, there would be some porthole or square, call it grids, that would be here exhausting vapor and atmosphere with their cooling system, you might say. And there would be here not a saturated amount of this radiation, but it would be as they ran through the atmosphere or air that here some would be attached to their skin and to their clothing, you'll say, like a light amount of airborne radioactive particles floating in the air, you'll say. They ran through the same, or through the, call it trail or vapor, as if one would walk through the vapor of an automobile sitting on the sidewalk on a cool day, the exhaust being warm or hot would cause a cloud to stream out from the tailpipe, and one would walk through the same, and there would be some scent of carbon monoxide on them, you'll say. Likewise, there would be, in a similar way, passing through a, not a cloud, but an area, which there would be some of this vapor or suspended radioactivity particles. It would adhere to their clothing, you'll say. They do not have them migrating or being interrogated, but have them moving quickly through what would be a large cloud, although it was not vapor or water vapor, nor was it thick with its materials or direction.
Briefly, why did two victims have fractured skulls and two have broken ribs?
As we have given, they were pummeled indiscriminately. While they lay on the ground, they were hit, both fists striking the body at the same time. A unusual way, not a swing like a human would swing one fist at another, but rather taking both fists and simply pummeling or punching downward at the same time, struck the body wherever they did, head, chest, side, arm. Once there was a knocking down and little movement, they were left and the animals moved on, you'll say. Quite a frightening time for everyone, including those who would be observing, you'll say, direction.
Why was one missing her tongue?
Bit the same, you'll say. Fell from the mouth. Pressures, you'll say. Pummeling, falling. These were all pressures, you'll say. Internal, like one who would fall from a slight elevation. There would be striking of the teeth, or there would be the bone striking, and there would be internal pressure cuts, you'll say. When one falls and hits their head on the ice, the skin breaks open. This can happen on the outside of the skull or on the inside, against the skull, you'll say. Direction.
Why was one of the tents ripped or cut open from within?
Trying to escape, you'll say. Panic ensued here. There would be screaming, and those left behind, or latter to get out of their garments, escaped, you'll see, by cutting a hole in the side, ripping a hole, you might say. Direction.
Did the Russian military have any influence on what happened?
There was no military cause here, but there would be some knowledge of this, you'll say, if this is what the question is asking us to seek, you'll say. Direction.